dull and boring without no trains moving. So we're here at Wansford station. This serves the village of Wansford in the city of Peterborough, unitary authority of Cambridgeshire, historically Northamptonshire. So we can see the station building survives there on the right as a private residence. The Nene Valley Railway's own station is here on the left, although I think this was a new build after they reopened the line for heritage. This is where the line from Stamford East terminated at. We can see we've got some other railway related locomotives and steam powered services hiding there in the beyond the shed, as well as Wansford station sign. Now a quick little bit of context, the Nene Valley Railway is a heritage railway in Cambridgeshire and partly in Northamptonshire. This railway actually operates on the former Northampton and Peterborough Railway, which connected the cathedral city of Peterborough, which was then in Northamptonshire, with the county town of Northampton, in which is still in Northamptonshire, of course. It went through the towns of Oundle, Frapston, Wellingborough, and also Irvingborough and Raunds. As we can see here at Wansford, this is the main base and main running operating base of the Nene Valley Railway. Nene Valley Railway also has another claim to fame, that the rock band Queen actually recorded their song Breakthrough, and they actually recorded it on this railway.
Enjoying yourself?
I thought you were going to get me. Yes.
It's a little hard on the feet after a while, that's the only thing.
It's beautiful weather, and it's horrible wearing makeup in beautiful weather like this.
Yeah.
But it's going very well. It's not the kind of thing you do every day.
It's getting more
and more. Oh, I was supposed to wear my bloody shades for that as well.
I was listening to the song, you know.
But it had this suggestion of like an express train. And then I think Freddie and I came up with the idea of having a train and calling it the Miracle Express.
1, 2, 3, 4, breakthrough!
Okay.
I believe they went where that tunnel is, which takes the A1 over the railway, but I could be wrong, could have been further along the line. But the point is, this line has had a little bit of claim to fame with Queen, who are of course a well-known rock band, Freddie Mercury of course. But point is, the Nene Valley Railway has got a bit of claim to fame there, and is also a fine example of heritage railways down here in East Anglia. Probably should have come on the day when the trains are actually running. So, if we look quickly back over here, so we're facing towards Peterborough this way, and if we focus back here, we're facing back to where the railway to Northampton went, which is obviously where the Nene Valley Railway now occupies. So I'm trying to work out quickly on them. I'll have to find a survey map, but I'm trying to work out which side is where the junction to Stamford ran, as you can't really see it.
Hello
there, you're right.
Yes, you.
I just wanted to ask, I've just been to do the old railway that used to come from Stamford down into Wansford.
Right.
And have Wansford Road Station where they want a dual cab.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know, are the Nene Valley Railway still looking to take the old station building from there that's currently abandoned and
yes.
rebuild it?
Is that still... it's still in the process, yes.
It's still in the
it
process?
It will get moved though, it won't stay there.
Are you taking just the building, or are you taking on the way office and the platform as well? Or?
I think it's just the station building.
Yeah. Okay, that's brilliant.
All right.
It's all right. That's all right. I wanted to ask a question.
No, that's no problem.
That's brilliant.
Thank you. It's still being worked out. We haven't released any information yet, but it's still being worked out at the moment.
Are they also in the process of expanding this railway to Andle?
No.
Or is Andle
correct? That would be an absolute dream, but you've got to put other things in place, so there'd be a lot of money needed for that.
I understand, That's brilliant. Thank you so much
for that. Right,
thank you.
Bye-bye
now.
So this is Wansford Road Station. This is the village of Wansford in Cambridgeshire and the city of Peterborough Unitary Authority. As we can see, the station is now abandoned. This is the busy A road. As we can see, quite a lot of traffic on this road. They want to make it a dual carriageway, which would see the station building, which is down there, would have been demolished, and they likely would have changed the junction layout, including taking part of the old railway bridge in or filling it out, filling in the cutting to accommodate another bit of the road. But like I say, it'll be interesting to see what they do with the... As we can see in the cutting below, it's been used for a dumping ground. So that's facing back towards Stamford. And if I can get across, this road is really busy. Nah guys, doesn't look like I'm gonna be able to get across. This road is too busy. But over there would be the other side of the bridge heading towards Wansford, which looks overgrown from this angle, but I can't clarify because this road is just too busy. The A47, that's the name of the road, sorry guys. Due to be taken down by the Nene Valley Railway and become part of the Heritage Railway at Nene Valley. But as we can see, the station's abandoned. I think it was only abandoned a few years ago, but they're just planning to, for the busy road up there, to double it, make it a dual carriage when this station would have been demolished. But they're hoping to bring the station to the Heritage Railway and reuse it by Peterborough. So we can see the platform survives. We're facing back that way towards Stamford and that way towards Wansford. But yeah, there's the cutting, like taking the road over the old railway. But it's inaccessible as it's in quite a deep cutting. So let's carry on our way. So we can see the platform survives. It's pretty much intact, the station. So yeah, the station, as we can see, survives. The other one, sorry, I keep forgetting the village names, but I'll put it in the link if I forgot it. But yeah, so the station building's there, and just down there is where the platform shelters would have been and the old way office. Like I say, it's now abandoned, so be interested to see what they do with this old station. But this was Wansford Road station. This was the creme de la creme I was hoping to get, and I did before they take it down. So we'll head on now to the next one. So we're at Ufford Bridge Station. Served the villages of Ufford and Southorpe in the city of Peterborough district in Cambridgeshire, historically Northamptonshire, and the Soke of Peterborough. As we can see, the station site here is still pretty much obvious. We've got the platform here going across from, excuse my hand being in the way, from the bridge down there up to here before it finally ends at this little mud lump. So the platform is in a very overgrown state. Obviously it's been taken out by nature and doesn't look like anything's been done with it. But if we look a little quick bit closer, you can see the brickwork of the platforms. And obviously the bridge that carries the traffic over the old railway. So under that bridge, we're facing towards Wansford. And back this way, we're facing towards Stamford. Now, another thing to note quickly is, unlike Barnack, which was not too far from the village itself, Ufford Bridge and Wansford Road stations were all pretty much at quite a distance from their respective villages. Although Wansford already had a station on what would have been historically the Peterborough and Northampton Railway, and then obviously this line that came into it as well, and certain other lines. Wansford station, both stations in fact, were quite a distance from their respective villages, given that the modern Wansford station isn't close either to the village, unlike as well as Wansford Road wasn't. It shows just how much these lines at the time and stations were in quite rural areas. Looks like an old gate pole. And this station here at Ufford Bridge is no exception to that, given that Ufford and Southall are quite a distance away from this particular station. We can see it's just been left as an access road to a farm, which looks like it goes up there on the old track bed. And then it ends back down there at the gate where I parked my car. We can see the road there. And the beautiful free arch bridge that takes the road over it. So, guys, this was Ufford Bridge. All that remains is the platform and the old bridge that crosses over it here. Here you are, a bit of a clearer view of the platform here, as we can see. But it's been a nice fine seeing the Ufford Bridge so far. This line is still got some nice traces of itself left, even though it's closed back in 1929 to passengers and for freight not long after. This line is pretty much in good condition when it comes to finding old railways in the area. So guys, this is was off a bridge. We're now going to go in. So I'll see you there. So we're here at Barnack Station. This is the village of Barnack in Cambridgeshire, under the City of Peterborough Unitary Authority. As we can see, the station building survives as a private residence. The track bed and station site have now been incorporated with both a garden and a road to an industrial estate. As we can see, the platform is long gone from the station building, unless it survives beyond that fence, but yeah, that's the station building. And if we come down a short distance in this garden from the public highway, you can actually see what looks like the remains of an old railway carriage here, which has since been converted into part of the garden. And we also have what I believe is the old station master's house here that still survives as a private residence. But as we can see, the level crossing they used to cross here is now long gone, with the main road taking traffic through. The level crossing would have been roughly here, carrying on back that way towards Stamford, and have gone this way towards Wansford. If we have a quick look here, where these cars are all lining up to go into the industrial estate, if we face roughly this point here, in this photo from Wikipedia, we are facing roughly to where the platform would have been and the station building, which we can see now is since changed. I call it Nene Valley because I don't want to mispronounce it, but calling it Nene or Neen. So sorry if you don't like my pronunciation of it, that's just my way of saying it. But anyway, point is, the station building here survives, so. This was Barnack Station, guys. So we can see the industrial estate there in the background. So we'll carry on now to the next one. Honey, you're touching something. You're touching me. I'm in the old town. I'm the old span. Can't you see? We're here at Stamford East Station. This was one of two stations serving the town of Stamford in Lincolnshire, in the South Caerstephan district. As we can see, the station building survives as private residences, and a little further back that way is the old engine slash goods shed, which also survives as private residences. As we can see, the station here is quite a fine example of the old railway stations at the time, and it's also this and the shed are also grade listed buildings, so they can't be basically altered or demolished. They've been pretty much kept in their original state. The only difference is newest blocks of residences have been built around the old railway station. Stamford is still served by the other station on the Peterborough to Leicester and those lines. And as we can see, Welland Mews occupies where the old railway used to be. Behind those block of flats is where the goods shed is.